Hi folks, my name is Evie Nevin and I want to wish everybody a very happy International Women's Day for 2022, and the theme this year is Breaking the Bias. And today I'm going to talk about my own experiences and talking about gender bias, particularly in medicine, and gender bias when it comes to diagnosing neurodiversity. So I have Ehlers-Danlos Syndrome. If anybody who's seen previous videos, I've talked about this extensively. And it took 26 years for me to be diagnosed with Ehlers-Danlos Syndrome, despite it being a genetic condition, despite me going to doctors for years, being in pain and fatigued and things like that. And originally, I was diagnosed with depression. And that's what we figured what it was. And then I was put on antidepressants. They weren't working. I was still tired. I was still in pain. Right, we'll try something else. I was still tired, still in pain. And funnily enough, it wasn't until when I was working as a journalist, it wasn't until I interviewed a woman with Ehlers-Danlos Syndrome that I heard about it, thought, this sounds a bit familiar. And then I went to a rheumatologist who had some knowledge of the condition, and I was subsequently diagnosed with it. And I remember when I was reading about it, I kind of knew in my gut that this one it was. You know, all the signs and symptoms were there since I was a baby, really. And you know, when myself and my parents were kind of thinking about it, we're like, well, you know, it really was obvious from the get-go. But the expertise just isn't there, and there's no kind of real will to change that here in Ireland and in many other countries across the world. So when I was diagnosed with Ehlers-Danlos Syndrome, it was, you know, the rheumatologist said to me, well, was it any wonder you were depressed when no one believed you? And it's interesting that women and girls tend to be more affected by Ehlers-Danlos Syndrome because of the hormonal involvement of having the condition. You know, girls with the condition will get really, really symptomatic in puberty, for example, or in women in pregnancy. And so, you know, like I said, things kind of kicked off really in puberty for me. But like I said, interestingly, the fact that women and girls tend to be more affected because of the hormonal involvement, and yet on average we wait 8 years longer than our male counterparts. And there is lots of research and clinical studies and everything that I'm going to talk about to back up why I believe that there is serious gender bias in medicine. And gender bias in medicine, it has serious implications. Studies show that women who are in acute or chronic pain are left waiting longer in hospitals, were more likely to be diagnosed with mental health disorders, even though there is clinical evidence to prove that we are in actual pain. When men and women, this is all backed up again by studies, when men and women showed up to A&E with, let's say, the same abdominal issues, same symptoms, women will wait longer than men for treatment. And women are more likely to be diagnosed, and again, my story and the story of so many other women with Ehlers-Danlos Syndrome and other chronic pain conditions, are more likely to be diagnosed with a mental health disorder than actual pain disorders. And again, like I said, even when the proof is there that we're in pain and that there is a problem that's causing pain. And we're more likely to be diagnosed with sedatives than we are with pain relief, even when we present the exact same symptoms as men. And when we do get pain relief, we're given less pain relief than our male counterparts, even with the weight control factored into for your prescription. And then this idea of women's pain being caused by emotional issues also does a disservice for men, because sometimes men's pain is stemmed for mental health issues, whereas in comparison, they'll be treated for the pain rather than the underlying issue of having a mental health disorder like depression. So it does gender bias does a disservice to both sexes, and but it is disproportionately affecting women. The most disturbing study I came across was a study called Beautiful Faces in Pain. And this study showed that doctors who deemed their patients to be attractive or beautiful took their pain less seriously. And it's this whole, it solidifies this notion of beautiful as healthy, or being of a particular build as healthy and things like that. And it was really disturbing, because if you have a doctor there looking at you thinking she's a good looking girl or she's a good looking woman, it does a disservice to people with invisible illnesses such as Ehlers-Danlos Syndrome and other chronic pain conditions. The whole notion of women being deemed emotional creatures and were neurotic and things like that, they're really, really harmful stereotypes that really need to be rectified in medicine, because women die. Women have died when their pain was not taken seriously. For example, women have gone into hospital with headaches and they were told, take this, you're going to take paracetamol, whatever, you'll be fine. And they've subsequently died of a brain hemorrhage. It happens so often. It really, really does. And until we rectify this, more women are going to continue to die. More women are going to not be believed. They're going to be deconditioned as time goes on. You put them on sedatives. Yeah, they're going to appear calmer because you put them on sedatives. It doesn't mean that they're not in discomfort and they're not in agony. If you're sedating somebody, then obviously they're going to appear calmer. That's been kind of my experience, and it's the experience of many women with chronic pain. Now, in terms of neurodiversity, because obviously this is on behalf of Neuro Pride. So I was diagnosed with Ehlers-Danlos when I was 26. I was diagnosed with autism when I was, I'm almost 35. So I was diagnosed when I was 33. And it was, again, like Ehlers-Danlos, when I kind of started reading more about autism and how it presents in women, and particularly in adults and stuff like that, again, it clicked. And it was funny, because when I got the diagnosis, so many people that I know, and particularly family and stuff, were like, I always wondered, were you autistic? Kind of like, never said anything. And I suppose, particularly when I was a child, there was always kind of worries of, would I be written off? And because it really wasn't understood as well as it is now when I was a child. And it was very late in life when I was diagnosed. And again, because girls and teenage girls are deemed emotional and overdramatic and things like that. So until all gender bias is, erased, women are going to continue to suffer. And again, as I said, the stereotypes put on men and women also do a disservice to men. So I hope this was educational for people, and it opened some people's eyes about what goes on. And hopefully, if you are a medical professional watching this, that you think about this in the future when you're treating women with chronic pain. Thank you.